Hey, what's up? Wow, that was sick. Oh, they made the whole box. Look at that. I mean, there's no need to use brand new priority mail packaging and doctor it up to make it look like it's a first class, you know, package. This guy did the right thing. And I bought from him before.
And I'll buy from him again. Got two things here.
Bundle of figures. These are, I believe they're made by HG Toys.
Ash, can you see this?
For their, amongst other things, Buck Rogers playset in around 1979. I'm looking to see if they have Hong Kong on the top of their base, but they're
essentially copies of figures crafted by Matchbox for their Battle Kings Adventure 2000 toy range, made
in 1976 or 77. This is an original. He has sort of a square edge to his base. Replicas by HG Toys will have a rounded lip to its base, and they'll all be marked Hong Kong. I'm just noticing right now that these are interesting. They're of a different color. The rest of these here are all HG. Did I get one of each variety? No.
There's two poses of figures carrying long guns.
And then the commander figure. And I believe they are referred to as Space Commandos. Or commando figures.
Just what the relationship between HG and Matchbox may have been, I do not know. The figures are more or less identical to the originals.
So on either side are the replicas by HG Toys, and in the middle is the original by presumably Matchbox Lesney in England. He's made in Hong Kong. And I've got to pick out one of the commander figures. I guess those are the ones that I've got the most of. To paint, and that's the one. His head looked a little bit somewhat worn. And why not take a gunner also? This is the one. They'll end up in the orange suit crew. And speaking of which, we brought home some more of the aliens.
So the footage from this part of the opening is pretty much unusable. We got a nice bunch of these LP Toys aliens. Though I can't remember which ones right now. My favorite is this guy here with his arms up, and all of them were presumably supplied by LP to HG for their Buck Rogers sets.
The two chromed are in hard plastic, and they are very clearly marked with the LP Toys logo. The orange ones were damaged pieces that I painted. I really want to paint one of these guys here as well. And I seem to have a couple extras at this time. Space Age convertible open top car design Midgetoy, Rockford, Illinois. I'm not sure if it's a repaint. The paint is just gorgeous on it. I'm tempted to hope that is an original paint job, just in factory mint condition. I will take very good care of it. And of course, it has the open top, and hopefully we can fit. No, he's still a little bit too big. I was hoping I could get one of these spacemen in there, but I'm thinking about adapting. I've got an extra golden astronaut or three, and thinking about taking a couple of them off at the waist to make sitter figures.
You get so distracted by the spacemen. Look at the detailing on this thing. No way is that a repaint. It just was never a kid's toy.
All original undersides, so it just looks like it's never been played with. Came into the hands of a collector who took care of it, Rockford, Illinois Midge Toy. Just over 4 inches long. Hot Wheels Mattel Dreammobile as a sort of size comparison there. So it's larger than Then the 1-64 scale of the Mattel vehicle, even though it's a fantasy ride. It looks like it's about perfect size for that guy. Oh man, we're gonna have all sorts of fun with this stuff. One of the reasons why these smaller scale figures are so appealing, here's a standard size NPC astronaut in comparison. These are the boxes that I scored like a gross of, sort of a volcano going off, and they fill up pretty quick. I mean, there's only really room in here for maybe one of each having an interesting meeting there. I gotta start disciplining myself to try to keep the surfaces flat so I can put in whatever I want. This one does a better job of that. Little pond and a waterfall spilling over, continuing on the underside. Because if it's hanging on a wall, people are going to be able to, even if they have to look down, what's going to be on the bottom? Is it just going to be the plane box? No! It's got to, you know, what's on the other side of a planet? More of the planet. Here they're having their non-violent encounter on the planet of whatever, next to the little burbling brook. Yeah, so here's a nice little update. Some of those micro astronauts from the big bundle of golden astronauts the other day, I couldn't get them to fit behind the steering wheel, but one of them rides quite nicely shotgun, and now they're hanging out down at the drive-in on a Saturday night. Some dude just pulled up in a Brooder sports model.
Chewing the fat, waiting for the girls to show up.